everyone, and welcome back to my channel. This tutorial is a bridal inspired makeup look which I created on my beautiful model Janita. I started off with her eyebrows. I groomed them neatly first before drawing the shape I want using my Yanga beauty brow pencil, like so. Kindly please excuse my dry, crusty hands. I forgot to moisturize my hands before starting the tutorial. I continue to fill in the brows gently and also brush it as I go with the spoolie on the brow pencil. I went on to shape up our brows with some of my coastal scent concealer, going up and down the brows and carefully erasing the unwanted shape, like so. Once I'm satisfied with the brow shapes I've just concealed, I go over the brows with some brown brow gel to set the brows and also give it a natural brow effect. I went on to blend out the excess concealer around our eyes. After that, I decided to color correct our eye shape because they're a bit darker than the rest of our face. So I'm using my orange corrector. I blend it all out and I applied a little light concealer over it. Once that is done, I set it with a translucent setting powder, like so. Onto the eyeshadow application, I started off by applying some transition colors on the outer corners of our eyes, and I keep blending back and forth until I'm satisfied with the blend. I went on to apply my NYX Cosmetics eyeshadow base. It's a jumbo pencil. I blend the base smoothly on the eyes before applying some whitish silver eyeshadow. All the products used will be listed below. Please, please, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. My very good trick towards creating a good eyeshadow shape is following the natural crease line of each person's eyes. This makes it easy for me to blend and also make sure I don't go overboard. So over here, I'm just blending. I like to use different brushes to blend. Once that is done, I went on to apply my Stila Cosmetics liquid eyeshadow, like a glitter-like liquid. So I'm applying it and also blending the crease area to make sure the glitter doesn't go overboard. I noticed that it went a bit higher on the right hand side eye, so I made sure that I blend it and make sure that I didn't make such a mistake again on this one I'm currently doing. So here I am just blending back and forth using different types of brushes to achieve the natural blend. After that, I decided to smoke the outer corner a bit more with a darker brown eyeshadow. I'm blending it back and so as well. Yeah, this is the darker brown eyeshadow I used to create a darker outer corner smoky look. After blending them both, I went on to highlight the brow bone area of her eyes, like so, using a soft and gentle MAC highlighter. I blend it together with the transition to make sure there's a seamless blend. After that, I went on to apply my liquid liner. I'm using a liquid liner by NYX. I take my time while applying it to make sure that they are not too thick or thin. I also went on to apply a black Kohl pencil on my waterline. Every time I apply a waterline Kohl pencil, I always like to set it with a black eyeshadow. Next, onto the face, I prime that face with Pond's Oil Control Primer, which is what I'm applying currently now. Once I'm done with the application, I go on to apply a foundation. But just before the foundation application, I color correct our under eyes, like so as well, and I blend it together with the foundation. I'll be using a Lancome, I think it's a Lancome, I'm gonna list it in the bottom section. I'll be using a Lancome foundation and blending it with my beauty blender. I like to use foundation brushes most of the time, but once in a while, if I want to create like a soft natural foundation application, I like to use my Beauty Blender because it soaks up the foundation and allows a lesser amount of foundation to apply on the face. So here I am just applying the foundation all over our face like so. I make sure I blend them in properly, and once I'm done, I use a smaller shader brush to apply the foundation under our eyes, because the Beauty Blender cannot go under our eyes more like I would want it to. So I'm using this flat brush to apply the foundation. I'm using that to also correct the upper part of our brows to make sure there's no halo effect. Once that is done, I go over it with my Beauty Blender as well. Then I go ahead to highlight and contour. So I'm using my ColourPop No Filter Concealer to highlight our eyes. So I'm going to be highlighting our under eyes, our chin, and the middle of our nose, so the bridge of our nose, and our forehead. I like to apply the concealer and blend as I go so that it doesn't get dry and make it difficult for me to blend. So I've just blended the under eyes. Next, I'm going to be blending the chin, the bridge of our nose, and our forehead. I always like to take my time during this process because it's the way you blend the concealer that the powder you're going to use to set it is going to sit on it. So if it's not well blended, you won't have a flawless blend or a flawless powder or a flawless application overall of the skin work. So I take my time. After this is done and I'm satisfied with the blend, I'm gonna go ahead to contour. I'm gonna be using my Black Ops stick to contour, and I'm gonna be contouring the two sides of my cheeks, our temples, like so around our head, and a little bit on the sides of our nose. Like I said as well, I like to blend as I go along. So I'm blending the chin, sorry, I'm blending the sides of our face and our forehead before going on to apply the ones for the nose as well. I take my time to blend to make sure there's no ash line and you can't really see where each section starts or ends from. Skin work, trust the process. So once I'm satisfied with the skin process, with the skin blend, I go onto the nose like I said earlier. So I gently apply the concealer on the two sides of our nose, and I blend it as well with my Beauty Blender. And once that is done, I go on to setting the face. So I'm setting our under eyes with the concealer, the lighter concealer for them. Setting it with my RCMA translucent white powder and my Mercier translucent powder. So I set the under eyes, the chin, the bridge of our nose, and our forehead. I like to use a smaller brush to apply the setting powder on the bridge of our nose and our forehead to make sure I keep in line where the powder is going to be. Once that is done, I apply my Anastasia Beverly Hills contour kit powder for the contour area. So I keep going back and forth blending the contour powder. And once I'm satisfied, I go on to use a smaller blending brush to apply the nose contour as well. Once that is done, I go on to use my powder brush to brush away all the excess setting powder before setting the overall face with a face powder. I'm gonna be using my MAC MSF, so my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Powder in Sun Power, to blend the rest of the face, to blend the whole of the face and bring some warmth back onto our face where the white powder has brought some whitish effect. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm going to be using this, then I'm going to be using a smaller brush, blending brush, to apply the inner part of the eyes like so, and also the upper part of the brows. This is where the normal big powder brush cannot reach. Once that is done, I went on to reapply my contour on the sides of my nose before going on to apply the blush. I'm using my Juvia's Place blush palette, Sahara blush palette. So I'm applying it on our cheeks like so. I'm blending it with the powder brush to make sure that everything sits properly. Next is the highlight. I'm using my Anastasia Beverly Glow, that glow highlight. First, I like to mix my highlighter, so I went over it with my Yanga Beauty Candid Glow highlighter powder just to give it that extra glow. So I went on to blend the rest of the face to make sure everything sits right. I applied a bit of a highlighter on the pupil bow, on the bridge of her nose, a little bit on her chin and her forehead just to give that glowy effect. I set the whole of her face before going on to shade her under eyes just to give that extra drama on the eye. After this is done and I'm happy with that, I apply my false lashes. I'm using some 3D lashes on that. Once I'm satisfied or once I'm done with that, I go over the lash band with my NYX liquid liner again just to make sure everything is well closed up. Remember every single teacher laughing at my vision. Looking back, I'm glad they did that. I bought my work ethic into everything. I go on to apply a big mascara on the upper part of her eyes just to make sure the lash, false lashes and her lashes are stuck together. Then I use a smaller mascara for the under eye eyelash. I applied some highlighter into her tear ducts to open up her eyes a bit more. And once I'm done with that, I went on straight to the lip application. For the lips, I'm gonna be using my Chestnut MAC lip pencil. First, it's a brown pencil. I'm using this to outline her lips. And for the lipstick, I'm gonna be using my Stila liquid matte lipstick. I'm gonna put the name below. So I apply that on the upper and lower part of her lips and ask her to blend it together. Once she's done blending, I use my lip brush to further blend it. And once I'm satisfied with that, I apply a liquid lipstick. This is from Colourpop, I think. Yeah, I'm gonna put that name below as well. I love this lip gloss. So once I'm done with the application, I go back with my MAC lip pencil to further outline the outer part of her lips. Once I'm done with that, this is always my finished or my final bit of lips. I always like to clean the outer corners in case the lipstick bled and to also sharpen the shape of our lips. I'm using a normal foundation color to do this. I apply it with a flat shader brush, then I blend it out with my beauty blender like I'm doing right now. I set it all around with our powder, with the color powder of our face. Once I'm done with that, I decided to go over the lip application again with a normal clear lip gloss. Then I give our face one more face set, and that is it. This is the end of the look. So here is our before, and this is the finished look. I thoroughly enjoyed creating this look and I really, really love the outcome. I hope you all love it as well. Thank you so much for watching. Please, please, please don't forget to subscribe as usual. Drop a comment in the comment section if there's anything else you'd like me to do. And hopefully I'll see you again in my next video. Thank you. Bye. Incomparable, we just say the same. I'm riding for a meeting, y'all just riding for the fame. Honestly, I'm thanking God for everything that I became. I could probably be like you, but I've always been different. Only riding music sober, you ride only when you're lifted up. I know I'm gifted, but it wasn't given. I was in my room way before they ever gave attention. Now it's happening, so everybody's showing love. Remember shows when nobody ever showed me love. Did a headline, used to only open up. Lately I've been chilling, so it's time I get my focus up.